Charities have become the biggest losers in the David Jones sexual harassment case. After being promised millions of dollars from punitive damages, the out-of-court settlement has seen them end up with nothing.
$850,000 richer, Christy Fraser Kirk was ready to celebrate.
I'm going to go and have a nice day, I think.
What are your plans for the day?
I'm going to go and have a lunch with a good girlfriend and just relax.
3 months into her record $37 million lawsuit, the deal was hammered out over 9 hours.
Christy, anything to say at all? You're looking very, very happy there.
I've got no comment yet, guys.
But despite this promise on federal court-awarded punitive damages...
All of that money will go to a charity to help those affected by sexual misconduct at work.
Ms Fraser Kirk now says as the court will no longer be determining the case, that's no longer possible. A poll of 24,000 people found most believe at least some of the money should be donated. No sign of Mark McInnes, who also released a statement. I have repeatedly said that the vast majority of the allegations are simply untrue and an abuse of the legal process. I am looking forward to a resumption of my career in 2011.
While the payout falls well short of $37 million, it's still well above what most victims of sexual harassment are awarded by the courts. And now support groups hope other young women will have the courage to speak out.
Good on Christy. It's a very hard decision to make. You go to work to earn a quid, not to put up with this sort of rot.
But with a large chunk of her payout lost on legal fees, the long lunches won't last forever. Brett Mason, 10 News.